big way. Yeah, right. Not my kids either. But somebody's kids are coming in a big way, I'm sure. That's a great cut for carrot cakes, carrot and salad toppings, which we're going to use it here for today. Now, a lot of people out there don't like celery. It has a lot to do with these tough, stringy fibers that always get caught between your teeth and gums. Those of you who have your own snappers know what I'm talking about, right? All I got to do is take those tough, stringy fibers, place them away from the blade, and watch closely. This is the only machine in the world that not only chops celery for tuna fish soups and salads, it de-strings it in one complete operation. Wow. You think that's impressive? Pay attention. Have you noticed the whole time I've been cutting, there's no juice dripping from the cones? That's because these blades are cutting your vegetables, they're not crushing them. But would you believe, from one small stalk of celery, how much juice you're going to get? See, the juice of the vegetable is the flavor of the vegetable, and it's one of the most important elements. Now, we're going to go ahead and make you a salad. Is that all right? Ladies and gentlemen, you should eat a salad each and every day. Cancer societies across the world tell us that every year, thousands of people are diagnosed with cancer of colon. Most of them are living. It's primarily a result of lack of roughage and fiber in your diet. You should eat a salad each and every day. When we make salads at Saladmaster, we use cabbage. Cabbage is rich in potassium, magnesium, phosphorus, iron, vitamins, and minerals. It's a high fiber food and a natural laxative. At 40 p a kilo, it's an excellent buy. They say you eat with your eyes and digest with your stomachs. If that's true, red cabbage is delicious. Now, if you like coleslaw, look at that. All you gotta do is toss that with a little mustard vinaigrette. You got a beautiful, healthy coleslaw for you and your family. Now, cucumbers, don't peel them. See, a lot of people today like to peel the cucumber. If you want to get rid of the wax and oils, spray them with a little bit of vinegar water, twist and dry with paper towel. See, vinegar will take the wax off the floor, it'll take a wax off the cucumber as well. We've been giving you that fancy waffle cut since 1946. Ain't that impressive? Zucchini squash, yellow squash, and courgettes. You ever notice anything that looks good tastes better? Ladies and gentlemen, how about radishes and mushrooms? If you're chasing them around the cutting board one at a time, all you got to do is put a whole cup down the back and run them through in just a few seconds. Now, that's a healthy salad cut for you and your family for six people, and that took me less than a minute. How about a big hand for that salad today? Keep a salad like this each and every day, and you'll lead a healthier, happier life. Now, at Saladmaster, we don't recommend you eat crisps. I noticed some of you were eating them today, right? All right, busted. If you're going to eat them, why not make them at home? You know, it cost you £1.35 for a 5-pound bag of potatoes. Two bags of crisps, it's the same price. Take a potato, run it through cone number four, drop that in unsaturated oil for 60 seconds, you got mouth-watering crisps. Now, Wimpy's, Burger King, or McDonald's? Who's winning the French fry battle today? Win that battle at home. Look how many French fries you get from one potato. You know they're charging you a pound a bag? They charge you a pound a bag. No wonder they got golden arches. Probably solid gold by now. Any French fries from one potato. Now, I got a lot of cooks in the audience today. I've been told, but let me ask you a question. How many people out there love cooking with onions?
Yeah.
Excellent. How many people like diced onions? That's why your supermarket sells it in the freezer section, already cut up in a bag for three times more money, right? Not with this machine. All you got to do is take an onion, cut it in half from top to bottom. Remove the root pieces on either side, leave the skin on, and watch closely. This is the only machine I know of that not only chops your onions, but if you look out the back, guess what? It peels it in one complete operation. Ladies and gentlemen, it does it so fast you don't even have time to cry about it either. Now listen, I want to be serious with you for a minute if I may. I joined our business in 1998, okay? And then at 27 years old, I knew I needed to retrain. I needed to develop skills that I did not have. Ladies and gentlemen, I also realized that if I mastered this machine, I would have control of my career. Now, 18 years ago, the guy who recruited me gave me some fantastic advice. And if it's okay with you, I'd like to share that advice with you today. Ladies and gentlemen, the first thing Lenny told me, he said, Scott, get a big bag of potatoes and practice cutting every day so you ain't scared. You ain't scared, that's what he said. And I said, Lenny, hold on a second. What am I going to do with all those potatoes? He said, Scott, advice number two, get some leeks and make soup. It's true. And the third thing he told me, and I tell you, it's the most valuable advice I can give you, he said, Scott, keep a Band-Aid in your wallet at all times. Now, I joke with you, but see, my relationship didn't start with this company in 1998. My relationship with this company started in 1972. I was 1 year old, just in case you were guessing. And in 1972, my father and mother hosted a dinner, and they were given this food processor, this machine. And it's quite interesting, you know, on that dinner party, not only did my mother and father invest in a set of Saladmaster, which was a great investment back then because it was $300, it was a lot of money in 1972, sounds cheap today. My aunt and uncle also purchased a set, and I can tell you from up here that four generations of my family have had their life changed by one gift, this machine. See, at Saladmaster, our gift to you and those who help you develop your business is this machine. Please understand there is a cost to it. And our dealers invest in your business for three very important reasons. Number one, we believe in our products and their life-changing abilities. Number two, we believe in our presentation and our ability to showcase genuine value to customers. But number three, and the most important, is we believe in you, our people. Join me today and help share our vision of allowing everyone worldwide to experience Saladmaster. I wish you a great career, and I ask you to remember four words. Four words. Get leeks, make soup. God bless you.
Saladmaster, this is the one question I'm going to ask myself. A scale of 1 to 10, 10 being high, 1 being low, where would you compare yourself to Scott? And I'm not talking about to beat yourself up, I'm just saying the scale. You understand me? You think you've practiced that before?
Yes.
You think you've practiced it more than once?
Yes.
Some of you, the only time you use to practice the food processor is on the dinner. That's not where you need to be practicing it. Now, if you get good at that machine, just pass me the food processor, Mom. Just pass me the food processor. If you get good in this machine, in using this machine, what is it worth? You understand? What is it worth? If you get really good in this machine, and I'm talking to the consultants now. Some of you are doing this machine an injustice. If it could talk, it would not go on the dinner with you. Yes or no?
Yes.
So all you got to focus on is booking yourself up solid so you got piled in it. How much does customer have to pay for this machine? It's free. Come on guys, I've seen people go on presentations and the customer did not book a dinner from a dinner. They did not come out with referrals. And I'm going, what were you doing in that home? Because if you can't sell this and this is free, you ain't selling that. Think about it. And if you get good at selling this, guess what's going to happen? Your diary is going to be full. And if your diary is full, your business is going to be full. And if it's full, you're going to recruit loads of people, and guess what's going to happen to your career? It's going to rocket, isn't it? So guys, make an effort in the month of March. Take one day, and you can master that machine. One day, you can master that machine, and then get your diaries booked up. So that you can go out and have a phenomenal career. Because the difference between the people who are selling you right now is they're out cooking you. That's all they're doing. They are cooking you. Does that make sense? So let's get good at that. Can we give Mr. Scott McDaniel another round of applause? mineral for a long time. Okay, but again, we've got our general manager now. This is the gentleman who, when I was a young man just looking to get into sales, recruited me, trained me, gave me some basic fundamentals that have stood with me and stood the test of time. And I remember when I got into Saladmaster and I started building the UK, I chased Mr. Paul Middlebrook around, I think, for a couple of years. I went, no, but I just kept pestering him, and eventually he gave it. And he said yes, and it's been a great contribution to Saladmaster UK, the growth of the Rhino division, our trainer executive, the one and only general manager, what can we say?
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
Good afternoon.
I've been in this industry for 6-7 years. And I only know one joke about cookware. Okay? Only one. In 6-7 years, I've only collected one joke about cookware. And if we have a good time today, remind me at the end to tell you about it. All right. Now, listen, I'm supposed to be giving you some tips about having a great push month. And I'm going to do that because that push month starts on Tuesday. All right? 31 days. What are we going to do with it? Sorry? It starts now. Push, push, push. Where's Lorna? Lorna, are you there? Lorna, I say this every push month, but Lorna used to be a midwife. And her favourite expression was... Push! Alright, stand up a second, Lorna. Go on, stand up a second. Go on, let's have a...
Push!
Now, I said last month, a couple of months ago, before the last push month, I said, look, you've got to be pushy as hell in sales. You've got to be pushy as hell. And I saw a few people in the room go, ooh. I said, but it mustn't show. Okay? That's it. You've got to be persuasive. You've got to be assertive. You've got to be enthusiastic. You can be pushy with your knowledge. You can be pushy with your enthusiasm. You can be pushy with your attitude. But don't be nasty, aggressive, pushy. That's not the business we're in. Does that make sense? Okay. Now, something I say to salespeople, first day of training, frequently, I say this to them. Be proud of being a salesperson. Don't hide in the shadows. Don't feel guilty because you make money when people buy something from you. That's not how it works. Tomorrow morning you'll all be driving on motorways and main roads and you'll see trucks everywhere going up and down those roads. Those trucks are packed to the top with stuff that's been sold. Nobody loads a truck up with finished goods until somebody like you or me gets a yes on an order form. Is that true?
Yes.
Those factories you'll drive past when you leave here today through the West Midlands Industrial Conurbation, thousands of factories, tens of thousands of people will be working in those factories tomorrow making stuff. And nobody gets to do an hour's work in a factory until someone like you or me gets a yes on an order form. Nobody types an invoice up in an administration department until someone gets a yes on an order form. Is that the truth?
Yes.
We've just come through one of the worst economic crises that I can remember in my lifetime. Now, the only reason I knew we started coming out of it about 5 years ago was every time I turned on the news, whether it was CNN or BBC or Sky News, every few weeks the reporter would say, house sales went up last month by 1% or 2%. Car production in America has gone up by 3%. Okay? Tesco's have reported a 4% increase in their sales. What does that tell you about the sales process? It drives the economy, doesn't it? We knew we were gaining traction and pulling out of that situation because people were going out there and selling more. When we sell stuff, people get to do work and transportation falls into place. People buy things, there's tax paid, there's VAT paid, and that money goes to the government, they invest it, and that's the whole thing. Now, I'm not saying the salespeople are the most important part of the economy.